Now, let us continue with the transcription process. Transcription is that DNA is converted into mRNA. Specifically, DNA is converted into mRNA, but along with mRNA, tRNA as well as rRNA also these are synthesized there. Transcription process occurring nucleus. But here, transcription process in there, three phases are there: initiation, elongation, and termination. During the initiation stage, at the promoter region, RNA polymerase is attached, and unzipping of the DNA leads to breaks with hydrogen bonds, and two strands of the DNA can be separated out. But here, please, all of you carefully understand that out of the two strands, one acts as a template strand only. If the transcription occurs for the both the strands, and on the both the DNA strands, if RNA is synthesized, so these both RNA strands are complementary with each other, and that's why after transcription, the both the RNA strands join together and form the dsRNA, which acts as a genetic material but cannot allow translation process. So there is no usage of the transcription process in this. That's why out of the two strands, one acts as a template chain. So template chain, it is also known as antisense strand. So you know that out of the two DNA strands, one acts as a template chain and one acts as a coding strand. અહીંયા એક બહુ મેજર મિસ્ટેક થઈ શકે એવી પોસિબિલિટી છે. તમને એમ કહે કે કોડિંગ સ્ટ્રેન્ડ જે છે તો ત્યાં આપણે અન્ડરસ્ટેન્ડિંગ એવું થાય કે કોડિંગ સ્ટ્રેન્ડ કોર્સ રિપ્રેઝન્ટ કરે છે. Yes, you are right that coding strand represents the cores, but no transcription occur on the strand. Okay? MCQs are of which type? Of this transcription. Sound. Tamne DNA upar no koi code tamne aapo koi. તમને ડીએનએ એક આખું ડ્રો કરીને આપણને ટેક્સ્ટબુક ની અંદર એક મોડેલ આપ્યું છે, એક એક્ઝામ્પલ આપ્યું છે, અને એમાં એ પણ કીધું છે કે એમાં ટેમ્પલેટ ચેઇન એન્ડ કોડિંગ સ્ટ્રેન્ડ કઈ કઈ છે. તમે સાંભળજો, સ્ટ્રેટ ફોરવર્ડ ક્વેશ્ચન કેવો થાય કે ઓન ધીસ ડીએનએ સ્ટ્રેન્ડ ટેમ્પલેટ સ્ટ્રેન્ડ ઇઝ ધીસ, સો વિચ આર ધી કોર્સ ઓન ધી એમઆરએ from this template chain. તો આપણે એમાંથી શું કરવાના છીએ, કોડિંગ સ્ટ્રેન્ડ ફોર્મ કરવાના છીએ. પણ કોડિંગ સ્ટ્રેન્ડ ઉપર જ્યાં જ્યાં થાઇમિન પ્રેઝન્ટ છે તો એ મારે એને ઉપર યુરિયસિક આવી જશે. સો વેન યુ ફોર્મ ધી એમઆરએનએ સ્ટ્રેન્ડ ફ્રોમ ધી ટેમ્પલેટ સ્ટ્રેન્ડ, યુ ફોર્મ સિમિલર સ્ટ્રેન્ડ ઓફ ધી કોડિંગ સ્ટ્રેન્ડ, બટ ઇન્સ્ટેડ ઓફ ધેટ થાઇમિન યુરિયસિક ઇઝ પ્રેઝન્ટ હિયર. બટ ટ્વિસ્ટેડ વાત એ છે, now the question is changed. If the DNA strand is like this, one strand acts as a template and one is as a coding strand, the question is changed like that. If coding strand become templated one, you assume that coding strand become template one, so which are the codes on the mRNA strand? So you have to select the template strand itself in that question, and on the template strand, wherever thymine is there, you have to write uracil there. Okay? So in this way, the question will be asked like that. So template chain is known as antisense strand. After formation of the mRNA strand, so on the mRNA strand, two things are there: exons and introns. Which can be removed? Which of these two fragments one is removed? Exon or intron? Introns. Introns can be removed. Exons are coding. Introns are non-coding. So intron fragments can be removed with the help of four molecules known as spliceosomes. And with the help of these spliceosomes, all the introns can be removed and all the exons are joined together. Exons are coding strand which carry the codes for the specific amino acid. Intron carries the code, but not for the specific amino acid. For extra amino acid, the coding strand carry the codes. So introns can be removed with the help of the spliceosome and by the process of the splicing. And all the exons are joined together, and at the last, all the exon continue, the whole mRNA strand will be formed there, and one end is known as 5' cap. And 5' cap is MG cap. MG3P cap, we say like that. Methyl guanosine triphosphate cap. So on the mRNA strand, one side methyl guanosine triphosphate cap is there, and opposite side 3-poly-A cap. Okay? And here initiation factor is sigma factor and termination factor is rho factor. And in this way, the mRNA strand will be formed there, and mRNA strand can now move from the nuclear pores outside of the nucleus, enter in the cytoplasm, and only in the cytoplasm or over the endoplasmic reticulum, specifically rough on that, that mRNA are situated on the ribosome for the formation of the protein strand. So this one portion you have to write in the board exam. If the 4-mark question will be asked that explain the transcription process. Okay, so this much portion you have to write in that. Now, here, specifically we say that transcription process is formation of the mRNA strand from the DNA. But here, we can't consider the tRNA as well as rRNA. Why? Because transcription process is followed by translation process. So here, main role of the transcription is to form the protein strand by the translation process. So mRNA strand provide the codons for the formation of the protein strand, and tRNA as well as rRNA are essential there. They are helpful RNA molecules. That's why here we majority consider the DNA is converted into mRNA, that is in the transcription process. But tRNA is synthesized, rRNA is activated, mRNA is formed. These all are included in the transcription process. So the one is transcription format ma pucha hai. So any define lakhvani chhe, where it occurs, e lakhvanu thase, why only one strand act as a template strand? If both the strands act as a template strand, then what happened? Initiation, ema sigma factor lakhi dejo, pachi releasing factor, ema rho factor, then mg, triple B cap, ODA tail, exons, introns, removing, splicing, spliceosome, and mRNA synthesis. So once you write this transcription process by yourself according to these topics in the sequential manner, then you can realize that which points we have to include in the transcription process at the time of the full mark question. Okay, which points you have to include there. This much points are included there. This is enough for you. Fine. And only you draw the one diagram. And in one diagram you include all the points. Okay, on the template strand you write the row factor, sigma factor, termination point at the row factor, fine, and then mg, triple p cap, 5 prime end, and 3 prime coordinate there. Okay, so many diagrams are given there in the textbook, but you can merge it in the one diagram only. Now here, in eukaryotes, three types of RNA polymerases first RNA polymerase 1 for 28S RNA ATS RNA RNA synthesis from this RNA polymerase 1, RNA polymerase 2, it is useful for RNA synthesis, retinonuclear RNA, it is precursor of the mRNA. and third is Paranayam Kodimara is 3. TRNA, 5SRRNA, and SNRNA. Synthesis. So, in replication process, 3 DNA polymerase 1, 2, and 3. As well as here same way in the transcription process, RNA polymerase 1, 2, and 3 are used there, a specific function is there. So in eukaryotic cells, RNA polymerase is also many types, but in prokaryotic cells only one type of the RNA polymerase is present, which forms the all the types of the RNA, snRNA, hnRNA, like that. RNA polymerase, that is coenzyme or equivalent bacteria, has 5 polypeptide chains. That is beta, beta dash, 2 alpha chain, and 1 is omega. Okay, so in this way 5 polypeptide chains are present. Sigma polypeptide chain is also known as sigma factor. So here, code enzyme, then it is beta, beta dash, alpha, alpha, and omega, plus sigma factor all are joined together to form the RNA polymerase enzyme in E. coli bacteria. So in E. coli bacteria, six polypeptide chains are present in RNA polymerase actually. In prokaryotic cells, before 10 nitrogenous bases from the starting point, 6 base pair TATAAT present on the DNA, this is known as Prignaud box, whereas in the eukaryotic cells,
thank you.
Eukaryotic cells before 20 nitrogen bases. From the starting point, a sequence of 7 nitrogen base pairs, and this 7 nitrogen base pair in the form of the TATAAA, sorry, here what A is remaining, I forgot to write that. Another A is there here. TATA triple A or TATATAT, like that. This sequence is present on the DNA, which is known as Tucker box or Hoogness box. Okay, so this Tucker box and Prim-Now box MCQ will be asked in the exam frequently. Transcription always occurs in the direction of the 5 prime to 3 prime. Okay, here in the transcription process, non-functional introns can be removed and functional exons are joined together with the help of the RNA ligase enzyme. Okay, whereas in the replication process, the DNA fragments are joined together with the help of the phosphodiester bond. This is very, very common. So, in DNA replication, DNA ligase is used. And here in RNA formation in the transcription, RNA ligase is used. Thank you. some specific proteins are used in this splicing procedure. Some specific proteins are used in this splicing process called as small nuclear ribonucleoproteins. In the short form, we remember as a SNRNP, or it is also known as NURBS. And this NURBS attach with other proteins and form the spliceosome complex. And this spliceosome complex attach at the both the ends. Actually, spliceosome complex in the four spliceosomes are there. Two are attached at the one end of the intron and two are attached at the another end of the intron, and all these spliceosomes are attached to each other and then cut the fragment by breakdown of the phosphodiester bond. By breakdown of the phosphodiester bond at the introns, and both the exons are joined together with the help of the phosphodiester bond. And then in this way, all the exons are joined together and form the polymer of which is known as functional mRNA. So this is about the transcription process, right? So genetic code we will take it in the next lecture. Here I can stop now.